Let's take a look at how we can create this interesting looking recess. This was inspired by a car headlight design, which is quite common nowadays. The challenging part about this recess is that it smoothly transitions from the cylindrical surface and gradually dives under. I will provide a link to the starting file so that you can follow along. Go to the sketch folder and show the outer profile sketch. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select the cylindrical face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Go to the sketch folder and show the line sketch. This line serves to pinpoint the location where the cylindrical face will start to dive inwards. We want to use this line to further split this face. Repeat the split face command. Select this face to split and select the line as a splitting tool. Activate the Surface tab. Select this portion of the face and press the Delete key. Once this face is deleted, the solid body becomes a hollow surface body with an opening. Begin a sketch on the top plane. Activate the Slice option in the Sketch palette. This will create a cross-section with the top plane as a sectioning plane. This allows us to see things better. Begin a control point spline. Attach the first point of the spline onto this vertex. And add another 2 points. Adjust the spline to go beyond the opening. Go to Project Include, Intersect. Select this face. This arc represents the intersection between the sketch plane and the face. We can now add a tangent relation between the spine and this arc. Make sure that the Surface tab is still active. Go to Create, Sweep. Select this edge of the surface as a profile. For Path, click on the Select box and remove the Chain Selection option. This is to prevent the arc from getting selected. Select the spline as a path. Go to the sketch folder and show the offset sketch. This sketch was made by offsetting the outer profile sketch. We shall use this sketch to trim the swept surface. go to Modify, Trim. Select the sketch as the trim tool. And select this portion of the surface to remove. To close this up, we will create a lofted surface. Make sure that the Surface tab is active. Go to Create Loft. Remove the Chain Selection option so that we can choose individual segments. Select this chain of edges to create Profile 1. Add the next profile by clicking on this plus sign. Select this chain of edges. This is still a hollow surface body. Go to Modify, Stitch. Box select all surface bodies to stitch them together. By setting the operation to New Body, the command would fill up the hollow to create a solid.